Hello and welcome to this video. Sorry for the German text, I will explain that later. But first to the purpose of this video, because a few days ago the LEGO Mindstorms Robot Inventor app got an update and now there are a few new options which I will cover in this video. So this will be a short overview about the new features, and there are change logs in the app stores that you can read. This is an example from the Microsoft Store, but there are change logs in the Play Store from Google and so on as well. So you can read that if you want. In my case, it's in German, so you can't read it, but sorry for that. So let's switch to the next thing, because there's also been an interview with a few people from the LEGO Mindstorms team, and most of this covers the update. But for me, the most important thing is that now it's officially confirmed that LEGO is working on hub-to-hub communication. So in the future, it will be possible to connect several hubs together. I'm not sure if they mean just Spike Prime and Robot Inventor hubs, or just powered up hubs, or both. Maybe it's just Spike Prime and Robot Inventor hubs, but we will have to wait until we find that out. And this article contains a few more informations. You can read it if you want. I think that I will link it in the video description. But now to the changes for the app. First, there's a new tab, this community tab. And here are a few builds or a few models from LEGO Mindstorms users, which you can build as well. This one has been in the software for quite a while, Pet Gilo. Personally, I don't like the building of the tail, because you have to put a few axles on a tube, or not axles, but axle holes on a tube, and the tube scratches a bit with that, and I don't like that, but the rest of the robot is fine. And yes, the community tab is the first change. I think that LEGO will add more fan inventions in the future as well. Maybe it's meant as some kind of replacement for the LEGO Mindstorms gallery, although it's not as fancy as the Mindstorms gallery was, I think, because in the Mindstorms gallery, everyone could submit the model and it would be published. And this one is only for selected builds. And then we have a few other changes in the code area, because here we have two more extensions that we can add. The LEGO Powered Up extension and the More Sensors extension. Because now the app officially supports all of the Powered Up hardware, so you can use the motors with the normal motor blocks. Keep in mind that you can't control the speed of motors that don't have a speed sensor, so the train motor and the medium linear motor have to use the power control blocks that you can find in the additional motor blocks. You can't use these set speed blocks for the train motor and for the simple linear motor. And then we have blocks for the LEGO Powered Up sensors. There are blocks for the LEGO Boost color and distance sensor. There are blocks for the tilt sensor from Vedo 2.0. I'm not sure how it's called officially. And there is a block for the distance sensor from Vedo 2.0 and from the piano from LEGO Ideas. So you can use these blocks for the sensors. Every sensor has its own image, and there are also blocks for the lights that you can buy separately at LEGO. And last, we have the option to read the raw RGB values from the color sensor. We have the option to get the force on the force sensor, because previously there was no block for that, and we can read the acceleration and the angular velocity of the hub, of the gyroscope in the hub. But that was it for this video. Are you interested in these new features? Please tell me in the comments. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video, and bye!